This shows how the fogger arrived. It's reasonably packaged and protected for shipping. It arrived undamaged. It came with an instruction manual and accessory cords, including the remote manual controller and the remote controller and the power cord. So what attracted me to this fogger is that it had a dual capability of using either ice or dry ice. Plus, it had a large tank capacity for fogging fluid. Plus, it had either a manual trigger or a remote controller trigger. Plus, obviously, the price point was quite good at $137. You unscrew two knobs at the top to open up the compartment which holds the ice and or dry ice. There's a V-shaped container on the inside for holding the ice and or dry ice. The interior surfaces that are black on the inside there look to be some type of rubber sheeting, I guess, to keep things watertight. This is the fog fluid container, which holds 2 liters of fluid, or about 2.1 quarts of fluid. The unit weighs about 26 pounds. You see there's a handle there, which is nice for lifting it and carrying it around, and it is liftable and carryable with the ice and or dry ice in there, so it's not terribly heavy, so it is manageable. So I sped up the video over the next several minutes to give you an idea of what the fogger was doing. A lot of the fog was being blown backwards where it shouldn't go, so that kind of made it so it would not fulfill the job of filling up the grassy area. Also, something I learned is that the fogger will not continuously discharge. It discharges for maybe a minute and a half, and then it'll stop for about 40 seconds or so until it will restart, so it will not continuously discharge. So because the wind was blowing all the fog between the house and the wall, I decided to move the fogger to the middle of the concrete patio, and the result was considerably better, as you can see here. So the location of the fogger played a big difference in the overall effect. Secondly, probably the highest, most important factor is the wind. If there's wind, the low-lying fog effect probably will not work very well. In Las Vegas, where I live, it is almost always windy, and on the night that this was filmed, it actually was much less windy than usual. So if you have a very windy location, the low-lying foggers will probably not do what you'd like them to do. To give you an area of coverage of this fogger, the grassy area is about 382 square feet, and the concrete patio area up to the stairs you see on the left is about 465 feet. So that gives you some basis for determining if the fogger can put out enough fog for your application and square footage. Once again, the fogger results will depend on the wind conditions. The fogger manufacturer states it is appropriate for areas between 10 and 100 square meters, which is about up to 1,080 square feet. Here's a bit more footage showing the fogger putting out its fog higher up to give you a better grasp of the area that it's covering. So a big question I had was dry ice going to be really superior in this fogger over regular ice? So here's about 10 pounds of dry ice that I'm pounding to a smaller size. The 10 pounds of dry ice cost about $25 at my local Albertsons, so it's not inexpensive. Here's the manual remote control for activating the fogger. Let's see how it looks. So you might be able to tell that the wind has picked up considerably, so it's difficult to compare the dry ice here in comparison to the ice we looked at previously. So I continued to test the fogger with dry ice, but the wind would just so much increase that it wasn't a fair comparison. And so I wasn't sure if the dry ice fogger was really much better than the ice. However, one conclusion I did come to was I was surprised how good ice alone was, and that in low wind conditions, I think it would be totally adequate for my purpose, and it is a very good value for the price. So overall, I recommend this fogger as being a good value, putting out a good amount of fog, and being worthwhile using just ice alone. Thanks for watching.